The monitor. You know, I actually think this is one of the most important yet most overlooked parts of a computer. When you see people talking about buying a new computer or even building a new one, of course the first thing you're going to hear about is the graphics card, the CPU, the amount of RAM, all that. But if you think about it, the monitor is the thing you're going to be staring at all day, so it's important to have one that you're really happy with. Now, if you already like your monitor, don't let me tell you otherwise, but maybe there are those of you out there who never really even thought about it. Maybe you're just waiting for an excuse to upgrade your current one. So in this video, I'll cover the reasons why you may or may not want to get a new monitor, the types of monitors, specs to consider, and just fun things to consider, because maybe I'm weird, but yes, I do think talking about monitor specs is pretty fun. And before we move on, I want to give a quick shout out to the sponsor of this video, Skillshare, which is an online learning community for anyone who likes being creative, really. It's got over 15,000 classes in technology, business, design, and a bunch of other topics. And you can take class, try out some projects, or even teach a class if you really want. And you can also get the Android or iPhone app too. It lets you access the content while offline. So for example, I'm big into photography, if you didn't know that. And there's a neat class about outdoor photography at sunrise and sunset, which I really liked because I enjoy landscape photography. There's a premium membership. It starts at $10 a month for unlimited learning access. And you can actually get 2 free months of unlimited classes with Skillshare if you use the link in the description below. So be sure to check that out. I think you'll enjoy it. All right, so let's get into the different types of monitors that are out there. Obviously, this is going to be pretty important so that you know what kind you have and also which one you might want to get next. Right now, there are 3 main panels out there, which are TN, stands for Twisted Pneumatic, VA, which stands for Vertical Alignment, and IPS for In-Plane Switching. There are some variations for each of those, but those are the main categories. Now, you might be hoping that I'll be able to say that one type of these is definitely the best, no debate needed, just get this one. But like most things, that's not the case, because each type of monitor has advantages and disadvantages that makes each one better for some purposes than others, like whether you need a gaming monitor or photo editing, and maybe even what types of games you play will determine which one would be best. So it's really not that simple. First of all, you should hopefully know what kind of monitor you have, or at least be able to figure it out. If you have what you might consider a typical monitor that you got either with the computer or bought it off the shelf because of the price, chances are you have either a TN or a VA panel. And these aren't necessarily bad, but they're less expensive and very common. On the other hand, you might also have an IPS, which are more expensive but have been coming down in price in the past few years. And knowing which monitor you have will let you know if maybe you don't have the best kind for what you're using it for. All right, so I'm sure you just want me to get to the point, what's the difference between all these? So how about we start off with TN panels? In general, these are the least expensive monitors, so they're really the most common, but there are exceptions, of course, to the price. TN panels typically have the least accurate colors and contrast levels out of all the monitors, so if you purely want to go for image quality, it's not the best option. That doesn't mean that the screen will look like crap, but the reds may be a little bit oversaturated, for example, or the black levels aren't going to be very deep, that sort of thing. So really, it's just not very accurate, as I just said. However, TN panels do have one major advantage over other current panel types, which is that they can have very short response times or input latency. So this actually makes them ideal for certain types of games like first-person shooters, where it's extremely important to be able to do flick shots or whatever very quickly and have your crosshair move as soon after you move the mouse as possible. A lot of times you'll see specialty esports monitors that are TN panels and actually are pretty darn expensive. And you might look at that and say, why does this monitor cost so much? It's just the TN, it's the worst kind. Well, it's because the whole thing was specifically designed to have a minimum input latency, and TN panel is just part of that. So for a special case like esports, you also don't really care about color accuracy either. But on the other hand, if you play something like League of Legends, input latency isn't as critical as, say, Counter-Strike, so you might not want to go for TN. On the other side of the price spectrum, we have IPS panels. Right now, these are pretty much the gold standard of image quality and color accuracy, and if you do professional photo or video editing and go to look for a color accurate monitor, they'll basically all be IPS. And not only are the colors and contrast better, but they have things like superior viewing angles as well. So the monitor will look better if you aren't looking straight onto it. And you'll also a lot of times see IPS monitors that are even 10-bit as opposed to normal 8-bit color. And you wouldn't know if you had a 10-bit monitor because they're typically, you have to seek them out. But if you aren't familiar with what that means, 10-bit, let me give you a quick rundown. Basically, 8-bit refers to how much information you have for each color channel to determine the pixel color. So 8-bit is 2 to the 8th power, and that results in 256 shades for each channel, red, green, blue, and 256 times 256 times 256 equals around 16 million total colors that the monitor can produce. That's really the only thing you have to know. But 10-bit is 2 to the 10th power, which is 1,024 shades of each. So that means that a 10-bit monitor can display over a billion unique colors. So it's no surprise that 10-bit monitors are going to be used by photographers, especially, for example, because they want to be able to see more of the color information that their camera captured. And believe it or not, raw camera images may contain up to 14-bit images. So theoretically, they can distinguish between literally trillions of colors. But I digress. Let's get back to the monitors. All right, so a good IPS monitor will look the best. So what's the downside? Besides price, the main downside of an IPS is that it's relatively slow. And by that, I mean the input latency or response time is much longer than, say, a TN. This also means that there will be more motion blur and that is more significant in fast-moving images. Right now, it seems like the fastest IPS panels, like those built for gaming, are around 3 milliseconds, whereas a TN might be less than 1. But a regular non-gaming focused IPS panel will be slower than that. Now, I'm sure many of you are thinking, are you kidding? Who cares about 2 milliseconds? And you're right. If you don't know any different, you probably won't care or even notice. All I know is that my personal anecdote is having used a gaming TN panel with less than a millisecond latency and then trying an IPS with 4 millisecond latency, it did feel off. Also, you'll want to consider that to get that low of a response time on an IPS, you'll have to cough up a lot of cash because IPS is already more expensive. I think for the vast majority of people, if you can afford one, IPS monitors will be the most enjoyable because they just look the best. And it doesn't make sense for the average person to sacrifice image quality just for the small fraction of time that they spend playing a specific game. It just isn't worth it. So then what about the third type of monitor I mentioned, the VA or vertical alignment panel? And this is pretty much a balance between TN and IPS, both in terms of image quality and price. It has decent viewing angles, color, contrast, and input latency. There really isn't too much other to say about this, other than if you want a good all-around monitor that won't break the bank, VA will get the job done. All right, so now that you've learned about the overall types of panels, you have to look at all the other specs. Now, I already discussed the bit depth and input latency, so I won't go further into those. The other main factors you'll want to look at are resolution and refresh rate. And again, the answer may not be so clean cut. We all would obviously love to have a super high resolution, high refresh rate monitor, but they simply don't exist, just from the fact that video cable technology can't handle that kind of bandwidth. For resolution, you can go from 1080p to 1440p to 4K, or even up to an insane 8K by Dell. And for refresh rate, there's the average boring 60Hz up to a whopping 240Hz today. And again, what specs you get will depend on both how much you're willing to spend and what you need it for. I personally think that everyone can benefit from high refresh rate monitors because on the desktop, it looks really nice and smooth. And for gaming, it's really like night and day. You just can't go back. So I think that no matter what kind of monitor you get next, seriously consider getting one that it's at least 120Hz before even considering the resolution. In fact, my monitor back there is a 1080p 240Hz because I'm crazy. On the other hand, if you're obsessed with resolution, you could go with Dell's 8K, But remember that at that high resolution, it's only a maximum of 60 hertz. Or if you want the best of both worlds, you can wait till later this year when I hear we'll be getting some 4K 144 hertz HDR monitors from Acer and Asus. Oh boy, which brings me to another important point about all this. You have to consider what refresh rate and resolution your computer can even handle. I don't think many people would be able to run their favorite games at 4K 144 hertz at anything above Lego quality graphic settings. So again, look at the use case before you buy. Though I did forget to mention one thing which may seem pretty obvious, which is you don't have to get rid of your old monitor when you get the new one. You can just hook up both and have dual monitors. Maybe you have one monitor for image quality and one for gaming, which is actually what I do. My second monitor is more accurate, so I edit on that one. Or maybe you want to get a new monitor specifically to be a second monitor and just keep your current monitor as a primary. There's nothing wrong with getting a second monitor just to have more screen real estate, and then maybe none of the specs even matter. Maybe, for example, you do like video game streaming or something, and you just want a second monitor to watch the stream chat, in which case the monitor could be black and white for all you care. So clearly there's a lot to consider when thinking about getting a new monitor, and if you don't feel that your current monitor is holding you back, then it probably doesn't make sense to get a new one. But if your monitor has been giving you trouble, or it doesn't do what you wish it could, at least now you know all your options. Or who knows, I bet there are some of you out there who maybe thought they needed a new monitor, but realize that the one they have is actually the best choice anyway. In any case, I hope you guys were able to find this video helpful, and I'd love to hear what you think down in the comments section. And don't forget to check everyone else's comments for suggestions as well, because obviously I don't know everything. If you want to keep watching, here's a couple videos I think you'll like, you can just click on those. And if you want to subscribe, I make new videos every Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. Again, I'm looking forward to hearing from you guys, so thanks for watching, I'll see you next time, have a good one.